Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Sometimes the most unassuming places tell the best stories, and this house has a great story to tell. What does this nondescript rambler have to do with digital retail? It has a lot to do with digital retail. But before I tell you the story behind this unassuming house, I'd like to take a minute and tell you my story. This is hardly my first big show. If I count correctly, it's at least my 25th, probably a few more, but we're not sure. But it is my first in this capacity. Many of you know that I joined the National Retail Federation just a few short months ago as Senior Vice President of Communities and Shop.org's Executive Director. And there's no one more thrilled to be here today than I am. I was drawn to this position largely because I'm passionate about digital retail. I spent years with some great brands like Tory Burch, Giorgio Armani, and the Gucci Group. And earlier in my career, I worked for one of the three companies offering end-to-end retail technology solutions. At these companies, I've led operations, technology, and customer service, and worked hand-in-hand with our digital retail teams. I see this position as my opportunity to give back to the industry that has given me so much. And to be honest and selfishly, I love the idea of surrounding myself constantly with the most innovative, admired, and successful people in all of retail. In other words, I love the idea of surrounding myself with all of you. Why? Because the digital retail industry doesn't understand the word no. You think differently. You laugh in the face of adversity, or, as was the case in 2009, a global recession. You're in the business of breaking down barriers, facing the challenges, and instead of shrinking, growing stronger. You're constantly thinking outside the box, dreaming up the next industry innovation, and creating must-have products, but more importantly, must-have experiences that we didn't even know that we needed. To most of you, taking a risk doesn't require conducting a cost-benefit analysis. It's simply a part of doing business. You are innovators. You're in touch with shoppers, and you're a constant inspiration to the retail industry. But digital retail as an industry is really at a crucial juncture. We're way past the early days when online retailers were either sinking or swimming, and companies were doubling or tripling their businesses every year. While it's true that online retail is still growing substantially faster than traditional retail, and we all know that mobile is growing by leaps and bounds, we realize that our channel is maturing, which is now creating a special set of circumstances, challenges, and opportunities for each of us. In an environment where we're communicating our brand promise and what the consumer can expect, and our identity across every screen, store, and device, will you be able to consistently meet the growing expectations of the evolving consumer? As digital retail continues to advance the overall retail landscape, we must ensure that our technology, our operations, our customer service are also ready to fire on all cylinders. You must be able to deliver what you promised. You must be able to deliver on your brand promise. We need to collaborate and be ready to learn from each other across internal business units and externally, taking the best practices from our retail verticals and our most innovative and strategic industry channels. That's why, for the first time ever, our Shop.org and NRF teams have put together a first look track at retail's big show, so that the thousands of retail leaders attending this conference could take this opportunity to experience the thought-provoking education and insight for which Shop.org is known, and immerse ourselves in the digital retail experience. During our first look track sessions and some of the other sessions that the Shop.org team has put together, we'll be discussing some of the most prevalent themes in digital retailing today. Globalization, personalization, and organization. So first, we're going to hear a lot about globalization. There's no doubt that the world is getting smaller, and retailers are looking to grow their businesses by expanding their borders. While that presents incredible opportunity for everyone, it also creates logistical hurdles. How should product assortment differ in another country? Where should shipping and distribution be facilitated? What payment methods need to be considered? We also realize that we have a lot to learn from many other countries when it comes to mobile retailing and mobile payments. In the US, we're barely scratching the surface on mobile. With such a strong international contingent at the show this year, there have been already and will be some incredible sessions on retail globalization at the show. And I really encourage you to seek them out. The next big theme throughout this year's First Look track is personalization, which embraces marketing, merchandising, site design, and social media. Today's shopper wants you to know them intimately, from understanding their preferences and offering pertinent recommendations to maintaining a dialogue with them on Facebook or your blog or whatever's pertinent. We've got some great speakers discussing this theme, including Amy Africa's session this afternoon on neuromarketing, and another session tomorrow featuring executives from Guitar Center, who will explain how they are empowering their local customers and how they can connect with their brand. You'll see how this is a true definition of an omnichannel shopping experience. And finally, organization, very important. It's really one of the most difficult decisions occurring in retail boardrooms today. Executives continue to grapple with the best ways to organize their companies and optimize the talent based on our new world order. Who does the e-commerce team report to? How do we account for mobile? Which data gets analyzed and cross-referenced? How can you integrate an organization while still fostering nimbleness that's so critical? You also have to be able to foster creativity and agility for what the web is known. If organizational challenges are keeping you up at night, you're not alone. And you shouldn't miss our session at 4 o'clock today, as a panel of retailers from Sheplers Westernwear, Tommy Hilfiger, and onlineshoes.com discuss the challenges and opportunities of streamlining your business. Of course, these are the issues we are dealing with today, but what is next? In just a few minutes, Forrester Research Vice President and Principal Analyst Sucharita Mulpuru will share insights on trends that our industry can expect in 2012. And tomorrow's opening speaker will be bringing in a crystal ball. You won't want to miss Twist Image President Mitch Joel talk about what to expect in the next 5 years of retail. Piece of advice for me, don't miss that session. So, speaking of a crystal ball, let's get back to the story of the house. The small, nondescript rambler in California that was home to a true retail visionary. And how many of you know who that is? It's not really the house that's important, but the garage. It is the house where Steve Jobs grew up and where Apple, one of the most beloved brands, was born. I don't have to tell you what an impact Steve Jobs made on technology and on retail. Most of us experience it every day. But Apple isn't the only retailer whose story began in a garage. Amazon.com, Crate and Barrel, Hobby Lobby, all began there too, among many others. In fact, several of you that I know personally in this very room and up on the expo floor worked in houses and garages and basements to start up your own retail and technology brands. I know you now have a slightly more sophisticated office space, or I hope so, and coupled with that and access to all of this brain power at your fingertips and all the opportunity to immerse yourself in the world of digital retail in the next few days, just imagine what you can do next. But as you all keep in mind the examples and legacy of exceptional leadership, design, and innovation from Steve Jobs and from Apple, remember the critical importance of how you implement and execute within your business teams, across your channels, and with every customer touch point. As we take our first steps to drive retail innovation in the coming year, I'd like to have you remember what author Walter Isaacson points out when he wrote about Steve Jobs' special vision. And it says, "There falls a shadow, as T.S. Eliot noted, between the conception and the creation. In the annals of innovation, new ideas are only part of the equation. Execution is just as important. There's lots of examples of that.